Thank you. Good morning, and welcome to historic St. Paul's Episcopal Church on this glorious Pentecost Sunday, the Sunday when we invoke the Holy Spirit many times. So buckle your seatbelts, because if she shows up, you never know what might happen. And she will show up. It's great to see kids here, and you know what? If they make noise, I'm mic'd. I can outdo them. Trust me. And I love it, so no worries there. Also, at the baptism, when the candidates and their parents and godparents and myself and the Paschal candle all head to the baptismal font, please bring kids back there so they can see. It's much harder for them to try to see over the adults when they're all standing. So bring them on back so that they can see at that point. And I'll remind you of that. We're making, again, a few changes due to COVID. Due to the fact that Sacramento County has moved back into the high rate of community transmission, we are asking folks to mask up again as much as they are able. And coffee hour will either happen in this building on a day like today when there's some glorious wet stuff out there known as rain. Such a nice thing. So we'll have it in the church after the service. Bigger volume of air, a little bit safer. If it's a nice day, we'll be back out on the sidewalk having coffee hour again. So we'll do that until such time as Sacramento County moves back to the lower rate of transmission. And I want to be careful because I want to go on vacation later this month. If you're interested, we still have some forward day-by-days, the little books of daily meditations. They're available in both narthexes. They go through the end of July, so there is still 2 months left in those books, so please grab one if you'd like to. And again, welcome both to those of you here in the building and into the diaspora that is Facebook Live and YouTube. Glorious Pentecost Sunday with baptisms. Yay! We get to initiate two more people into the household of God. So that'll be a wonderful thing. So at this time, I invite you to center your hearts into a place of prayer as we get ready to worship God in the beauty of holiness that's here in the building and the beauty of holiness that is the diaspora, Facebook Live and YouTube. And to assist us with that, we are welcoming back Randy as our guest organist, who will play a prelude followed by the opening hymn. Thank you.
life rises vibrant out of death. Come to create, renew, I inspire. Come kindle in our hearts your fire. You are the seeker, sure resource of burning love, the living source. Protector in the midst of strife, the giver and the Lord of life. In you God's energy is shown, to us your varied gifts made known. Teach us to speak, teach us to hear. Yours is the tongue and yours the ear. Flood our dull senses with your light. In mutual love our hearts unite. Your power the whole creation fills. Confirm our weak, uncertain wills. From inner strife grant us release. Turn nations to the ways of peace. To fuller life your people bring, that as one body we may sing. Praise to the Father, Christ his word, and to the Spirit, God the Lord, to whom all honor, glory be, both now and for eternity.
Alleluia. Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
There is one body and one spirit.
There is one hope in God's call to us.
One Lord, one faith, one baptism.
One God and Father of all.
Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, on this day you opened the way of eternal life to every race and nation by the promised gift of your Holy Spirit. Shed abroad this gift throughout the world by the preaching of the gospel, that it may reach to the ends of the earth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Please be seated for the readings.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. When the day of Pentecost had come, the disciples were all together in one place. And suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues, as of fire, appeared among them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages, as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and was bewildered, because each of one heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are not all these who are speaking Galileans? And how is it that we hear, each of us, in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt and other parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs. In our own languages we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power. All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, 'What does this mean?' But others sneered and said, 'They are filled with new wine.' But Peter, standing with them, raised his voice and addressed them, 'Men of Judea and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk, as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved.'" The word of the Lord. Okay, please join me in praying the psalm in unison, saying, "O Lord, how manifold are your works. In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Yonder is the great and wide sea, with its living things too many to number, creatures both small and great. There move the ships, and there is that Leviathan, which you have made for the sport of it. All of them look to you to give them their food in due season. You give it to them, they gather it. You open your hand, and they are filled with good things. You hide your face, and they are terrified. You take away their breath, and they die and return to their dust. You send forth your spirit, and they are created. And so you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in all his works. He looks at the earth, and it trembles. He touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God while I have my being. Many of these words of mine please him. I will rejoice in the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Hallelujah."
Thank you. A reading from Paul's letter to the church in Rome. All who are led by the Spirit of God are children of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back in fear, but you have received a spirit of adoption. When we cry, Abba, Father, it is that very Spirit bearing witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God, and joint heirs with Christ, if, in fact, we suffer with him so that we may also be glorified with him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Hail this joyful day's return. Hail the Pentecostal morn. Morn when our ascended Lord on his church his Spirit poured. Alleluia. Like two cloven tongues of flame, on the 12th the Spirit came. Tongues that earth may hear their call, fire that love may burn in all. Alleluia. Lord, to you your people bend, unto us your Spirit send. Blessings of this sacred day, grant us, dearest Lord, we pray. Alleluia. You who did our forebears guide, with their children still abide. Grant us pardon, grant us peace, till our earthly wandering cease. Alleluia.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Philip said to Jesus, Lord, show us the Father, and we will be satisfied. Jesus said to him, Have I been with you all this time, Philip, and you still do not know me? Whoever has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, Show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am in the Father and the Father is in me? The words that I say to you, I do not say on my own, but the Father who dwells in me does his works. Believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. But if you do not, then believe me because of the works themselves. Very truly I tell you, the one who believes in me will also do the works that I do, and in fact will do greater works than these, because I am going to the Father. I will do whatever you ask in my name, so that the Father may be glorified in the Son. If in my name you ask me for anything, I will do it. If you love me, you will keep my commandments, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another advocate to be with you forever. This is the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive, because it neither sees him nor knows him. You know him, because he abides with you, and he will be in you. I have said these things to you while I am still with you. But the Advocate, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, will teach you everything and remind you of all that I have said to you. Peace I leave with you. My own peace I give to you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled, and do not let them be afraid. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Acceptable, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Amen. Please be seated. Today is Pentecost Sunday, and I'm kind of a liturgical geek, so Pentecost is probably my favorite church holiday. I have what is called in fancy church words a high pneumatology, which simply means that I recognize the Holy Spirit of God working in our world, and that I look to the Holy Spirit as still accompanying all of us in our ministries. I have experienced the Holy Spirit move in my life in many ways. Times that disrupt me, times that call me into God's people. I also love today because it is the liturgical anniversary of my first celebration of the Eucharist. I was ordained on the eve of Pentecost 7 years ago and first celebrated the Eucharist on Pentecost. It's another way you can tell that I'm a church geek. I don't celebrate the calendar date of when I celebrated my first Eucharist, but I base it on the liturgical calendar, the feast day. And while my favorite color is blue, there is something exciting about flaming red vestments and all the red that I see out there. Today we remember that Jesus promised his disciples, both in his day and today, that he would have an advocate sent from the Godhead to accompany us on our journeys. We heard that promise in the gospel lesson. After Jesus tells his disciples that he will be going back to the Godhead and will prepare a place for him, which they're still not getting at this late date in the gospel, after that, Jesus promises that they won't be alone, that he will send the Spirit of Truth, the Paraclete, the Advocate, the Disruptor, to be with them and to be with us at all times. Now, the Holy Spirit is one of those people of parts of the Godhead that we don't quite get sometimes, but she is always around and comes to us. And you know, we try to contain God. We try to contain the Holy Spirit. People have tried to contain God for centuries, tried to domesticate God to make us feel comfortable. When the tribe of Israel was wandering the desert for 40 years, they were most happy when they thought God was in the Ark of the Covenant, in his box, in his tent. Didn't have to worry about God, he was in the tent. When they finally got to the Holy Land and finally were able to build the temple for God, they discovered that no box, room, or temple could contain God. The Book of Kings recalls that when they placed the Ark of the Covenant, where they thought they kept God, in the temple, God so filled the temple that a cloud filled the whole house of the Lord, so the priests could not stand to minister because of the cloud, for the glory of the Lord filled the whole house, the whole place. When Jesus was baptized, we hear that the heavens ripped open and the Spirit, in the form of a dove, descended on Jesus. A nice dove, a peaceful dove. We like that imagery. But that's also the dove that drove Jesus into the wilderness for 40 days to be tested. So maybe the Spirit's not so passive after all. Which brings us to our reading from the Acts of the Apostles. And thank you, Joe, for being able to get through all those nations. After the crucifixion, we've been hearing that the disciples gathered in a locked room for fear of the Judean authorities, for fear that there was a cross with their name on it. And except for going on a few outings, they remained in that locked room. We heard that Thomas went out doing whatever he did, and missed Jesus the first time he appeared to them after the resurrection. We hear in our accounts in the Acts of the Apostles that a couple of them decided that they were heading home and walked down the Damascus Road, only in to encounter Jesus and then run back to the locked room to let the others know. We read several weeks ago about Peter and the others going fishing, getting out of the locked room to go fishing, only to discover Jesus on the shore, who cooks them breakfast and commissions Simon Peter to be the rock on which the church will be built. Jesus told them not to be afraid. Jesus told them that after his ascension, that he would send the Holy Spirit to them. So after the ascension, we find the disciples where? Back in the locked room, which is where our reading from the Acts of the Apostles started. I'm not sure what the disciples expected. Maybe they expected that little placid dove and a voice from heaven to come down on them. Maybe some quiet breath blowing the animating force to them. I'm willing to bet that they did not expect God to show up in the violent rush of wind. And in my imagination, I got a good imagination. In my imagination, I can see that wind just blowing the doors off its hinges, blowing that locked door wide open. And God, the Holy Spirit, shows up, not as a placid dove, but as flames, fire. Fire is essential to us for warmth and cooking. But fire is also a disruptive force, even a destructive force. That fire of the Holy Spirit entered into the disciples and warmed their hearts, warmed their spirits, and drove them out of the locked room to proclaim the good news of Jesus Christ to the entire world. In our reading from Acts, we heard that there was a festival and that people from all over were in attendance. That list of countries that Joe read represented the known world at that time. There were Jews and people of all ethnicities that they knew of there in Jerusalem. And they amazingly heard the proclamation all in their own language. The Holy Spirit obviously also entered into their hearts. Of course, not everyone was receptive. Some believed that that strange event was not from God, but it was that new wine talking. It was strange. What else could explain the fervor with which these men who just very recently had been hiding in fear, were now proclaiming that Jesus has been telling them and showing them in his life, death, resurrection, and ascension, telling the people that this was the way to salvation and eternal life? There was no going back to the locked room for the disciples. They would go on to risk their lives to proclaim God's economy of love to a people of empire, a people occupied by empire, and an empire that would do whatever it took to keep them in power. Not much has changed in 2,000 years. Today, we still try to contain God in all the ways that our forebears did. We try to pretend that God is only present in our churches, or perhaps a couple of special places in nature up on top of the mountain. That we shut our ears, our hearts, and our beings to God calling us out of our locked rooms. But be aware, today is Pentecost. We are invoking the Holy Spirit today. We are especially invoking her in the baptism of Adonis and Amila. In a few moments, I will pray that the Holy Spirit who hovered over the waters at creation, that same Spirit to bless and sanctify the waters of baptism. I will pray that God the Advocate, God the Comforter, and God the Disruptor will come into our midst. We will pray that we will be receptive to her presence, which is always with us. When we open our hearts, and even when we don't, she's there. At my ordination sermon, my seminary advisor, Susanna Singer, used a wonderful quote from Annie Dillard, and some of you may have heard this quote. Annie wrote, "On the whole, I do not find Christians outside of the catacombs, outside of the place where they were buried, sufficiently sensible of conditions. Does anyone have the foggiest idea of what sort of power we so blithely invoke? Or, as I suspect, does no one believe a word of it? The churches are children playing on the floor with their chemistry sets, mixing up a batch of TNT to kill a Sunday morning. It is madness to wear ladies' straw hats and velvet hats to church, because we all should be wearing crash helmets. Ushers should issue life preservers and signal flares. They should lash us to our pews. For the sleeping God may wake someday and take offense, or the waking God may draw us out to where we can never return. We indeed are inviting God to draw us out of our locked rooms, to blow the hinges off of those rooms just like he did for the disciples, to draw us out where we can never return, to work to bring about God's dream of a different world that is not empire, a world where all God's beloved children are cared for no matter their race, their socioeconomic status, or who they love, where we care about the health and well-being of each other and the planet more than we care about money and power. In a few moments, Adonis and Imila will commit themselves to a life in Christ. I hope you brought your crash helmets. They will open their hearts and souls to God. They will be invited to open their hearts to hear where the Holy Spirit is calling them to disrupt our world. Bet you didn't know that was part of baptism, a call to disrupt our world. It's a call to enter into fellowship with all the saints as we work to find ways to turn our world right side up, to find ways to proclaim, in the words of our presiding bishop, Michael Curry, that if it ain't love, it ain't God. You guys will be making a promise to help bring about a different world, but not alone, but with God's help and with this entire community that we are all called to open to the Holy Spirit and to change our world. Amen. I need two of you right here. We'll do that little dance. There we go. Parents and godparents. We continue with the presentation and examination of candidates, which can be found on page 6 of our programs. The candidates for holy baptism will now be presented.
We present Adonis with Myra to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Okay, we'll do that again. That's okay. Well, we present. Go ahead.
We present Adonis Wade and Anilo Wade to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Cool. You both desire to be baptized.
I do.
Do you renounce Satan and all the spiritual forces of wickedness that rebel against God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world which corrupt and destroy the creatures of God?
I renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires that draw you from the love of God?
I renounce them.
Do you turn to Jesus Christ and accept him as your Savior?
I do.
Do you put your whole trust in his grace and love? Do you promise to follow and obey him as your Lord?
I do.
And y'all out there have a job to do to support these folks. Will you who witness these vows do all in your power to support these persons in their life in Christ?
We will.
They got your back. Now please stand as you are able. Let us join with those who are committing themselves to Christ and renew our own baptismal covenants. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ,
his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting.
Will you continue in the apostles' teaching and fellowship, in the breaking of bread and in the prayers? Will you persevere in resisting evil, and whenever you fall into sin, repent and return to the Lord? Will you proclaim by word and example the good news of God in Christ? Will you seek and serve Christ in all persons, loving your neighbor as yourself? Will you strive for justice and peace among all peoples and respect the dignity of every human being?
I will, with God's help.
Let us now pray for these persons who are to receive the sacrament of new birth.
Deliver them, O Lord, from the way of sin and death.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Open their hearts to your grace and truth.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Fill them with your holy and life-giving spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Keep them in the faith and communion of your holy church.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Teach them to love others in the power of the Spirit.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Send them into the world in witness to your love.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Bring them to the fullness of your peace and glory.
Lord, hear our prayer. Grant, O Lord, that all who are baptized into the death of Jesus Christ, your Son, may live in the power of his resurrection and look for him to come again in glory, who lives and reigns now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
If we can open a space here for a second. Perfect. And I invite the children to come on back with us too, as you want. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
We thank you, Almighty God, for the gift of water. Over it, the Holy Spirit moved in the beginning of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of their bondage and sin in Egypt to the land of promise. In it, your Son, Jesus, received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit as the Messiah, the Christ, to lead us through his death, resurrection, from the bondage of sin into everlasting life. We thank you, Father, for the water of baptism. In it, we are buried with Christ in his death. By it, we share in his resurrection. Through it, we are reborn by the Holy Spirit. Therefore, in joyful obedience to your Son, we bring into fellowship those who come to him in faith, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Now sanctify this water, we pray you, by the power of the Holy Spirit, that those who are here cleansed from sin and born again may continue forever in the risen life of Christ our Savior. To him, to you, and to the Holy Spirit be honor and glory now and forever. Amen. Oh, there we go. Adonis Wade, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Imila R. Wade, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit, you have bestowed upon these your servants the forgiveness of sin, and have raised them to new life of grace. Sustain them, O Lord, in your Holy Spirit. Give them an inquiring and discerning heart, the courage and will to persevere, a spirit to know and love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all your works. Imila R. Wade, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Amen. Adonis Wade, you are sealed by the Holy Spirit in baptism and marked as Christ's own forever. Now, let us all welcome the newly baptized. In the household of God, confess the faith of Christ crucified, proclaim his resurrection, and share with us in his eternal priesthood. The light of Christ. I got you good. The light of Christ. Now, let's welcome him. And as part of baptism, I get to do one of my favorite things, which is get you all wet. So I invite you to return to your seats. You do not need to keep those lit at all if you want. And you're invited to light them again on the anniversary of your baptism. The light of Christ. 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 You can get more, huh? The light of Christ. The light of Christ. The light of Christ. Oh, come on, we have to get you guys too. The light of Christ. Now, the peace of the Lord be always with you. I invite you to share a pandemic appropriate sign of peace. Peace, peace, peace to you here in the building, peace to the diaspora that is Facebook Live and YouTube. A note about communion. We're going to continue, at least for this week, offering communion in both kinds. That means the bread and the wine or the consecrated grape juice. Our theology says, however, that you receive Holy Communion fully, whether you receive just the bread, just the wine, or both of them. Yeah, please be seated. When you come forward, you can take just the bread and then walk away. If you would like to have the host intincted, that's a fancy church word for dipping. Have me dip the host in the consecrated port wine, which will be in the silver chalice, or the consecrated grape juice, which will be in the pottery chalice. Or you are allowed to take the bread, eat it, walk over, and take a sip out of either of the chalices. Just let me know what you want when you come forward. And at the time of communion, I will invite our newest members of the household of God to come forward first. Now ascribe to the Lord the honor due his name. Bring offerings and come to his courts with praise.
Lord, enthroned in heavenly splendor, first begotten from the dead, thou alone, our strong defender, liftest up thy people's head. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Jesus, true and living bread. Jesus, true and living bread. Here our humblest homage we pay thee, here in loving reverence bow. Here for faith discernment pray we, lest we fail to know thee now. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Thou art here, we ask not how. Thou art here, we ask not how. Though the lowliest form doth fail thee, as of old in Bethlehem, here as there thine angels hail thee, branch and flower of Jesse's stem. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. We in worship join with them. We in worship join with them.
Paschal Lamb, thine offering finished once for all when thou wast slain. In its fullness undiminished shall forevermore remain. Alleluia, 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 cleansing us from every stain, cleansing us from every stain. Life imparting heavenly manna, smitten rock with streaming side, heaven and earth with loud hosannas worship thee, the Lamb who died. Alleluia, 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 risen, ascended, glorified, risen, ascended, glorified.
Please join me as we give thanks for the gifts given this week, saying, praise God from whom all blessings flow. Give praise all creatures here below. Give praise above ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, mighty Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord, in the fulfillment of his true promise. The Holy Spirit came down on this day from heaven, lighting upon the disciples to teach them and to lead them into all truth, uniting peoples of every tongue in the confession of our faith, and giving to your church the power to serve you as a royal priesthood, and to proclaim the gospel to all nations. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and our archangels, and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest, hosanna in the highest. Blessed is the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest, hosanna in the highest.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all in the word made flesh, Jesus your Son. For in these last days you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him you have delivered us from evil and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, Jesus took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory, and we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this cup. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Blessed Paul, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to sing.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Christ's Passover is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
These are the gifts of God for you, the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. This is God's table, and all are welcome. I will invite all of you to come forward for communion. If you don't wish to receive communion, cross your arms and I will give you a blessing. That includes children. If you need gluten-free wafers are in here. I ask that you just receive the bread only if you need gluten-free, and I would invite you to just reach in and take one. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. You want dipped or just the bread? The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Dipped or bread? The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Just the bread? The body of Christ, the bread of heaven. Now I invite you to join us in our post-communion prayer of thanksgiving, which can be found on page 13 of our service programs. Together, let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with the spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart through Christ our Lord. Amen. May Almighty God, who enlightened the minds of the disciples by pouring out the Holy Spirit, make you rich in his blessings, that you may abound more and more in the Spirit forever.
Amen.
May God, who sent the Holy Spirit as a flame of fire that rested upon the heads of the disciples, burn out all evil from your hearts and make them shine with the pure light of his presence.
Amen.
May God, who by the Holy Spirit caused those of many tongues to proclaim Jesus as Lord, strengthen your faith and send you out to bear witness to him in the world and deed.
Amen.
And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
The church's one foundation is Jesus Christ, her Lord. She is his new creation by water and the word. From heaven he came and sought her to be his holy bride. With his own blood he bought her, and for her life he died. Elect from every nation, yet one over all the earth, her charter of salvation, one Lord, one faith, one birth. One holy name she blesses, partakes one holy food, and to one hope she presses with every grace endued. Though with a scornful wonder men see her sorrow pressed, by schisms rent asunder, by heresies distressed, yet saints their watch are keeping, their cry goes out, how long? And soon the night of weeping shall be the morn of song. Mid toil and tribulation and tumult of her war, she waits the consummation of peace forevermore, till with a vision glorious her longing eyes are blessed, and the great church victorious shall be the church at rest. Yet she on earth have union with God the three in one, and mystic sweet communion with those whose rest is won. O happy ones and holy, Lord, give us grace that we, like them the meek and lowly, on high
may dwell with thee.
Now let us go forth into the world, rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
A joyous noise to God. Making sure my mic's on. Thank you again for joining us this glorious Pentecost morning as we see the Holy Spirit inflaming all of our hearts. And congratulations to Adonis and Imila for their baptisms. It was great. I love it. Yes, thank you. Yay. And thank you for those joining us in the diaspora's Facebook Live and YouTube. I always enjoy it. You frequently might see me looking at my phone at the beginning of the service because I sometimes get messages from folks who are on the diaspora, and I got one today again thanking us for continuing this ministry. There's a cake back there, guys. So I think they're probably going to want you to cut it, or at least start cutting it, okay? So now please join us as you are able for a coffee hour here in the back of the church. There are tons of goodies back there. Please take care of each other. Stay safe. God bless.